Once again, I take this chance to welcome you, of course, in our math lesson, as we continue to explore different laws of indices. So far, we have been able to cover four laws. Of course, today we shall be covering our fifth law. Just a recap of the previous law. We said the first law was a law of what? Multiplication of numbers to a similar base. So what was the outcome? We said you do what? You add the indices. Law number two was the law of division of numbers to a similar base. The outcome being what? We subtract the powers or the indices. Law number three, if you're very keen, was a law of what? Multiplication of numbers to a similar power. We said the outcome will be the product of the bases raised to that similar power. Law number four was the law of division of numbers to a similar power. The outcome will be you divide the bases and let the outcome assume that similar power. So in our lesson 5, of course, remember, I am your teacher, Joseph Rudelopati. In our fifth lesson, we are going to go through the questions that I left you in lesson 4. The question in regard to the fourth law, that is division of numbers to a similar power. So 21 power 4 divided by 3 power 4, what do you get? We divide the bases, which are 21 and 3, of course, and raise that outcome to that similar power, 4. The outcome will be 7 power 4. Number 2, 20 power 3 divided by 4 power 3. What do you get? We get 20 over 4 raised to that similar power, 3. The outcome will be 5 power 3. Roman 3, 28 power 2 divided by 14 power 2. The outcome will be 28 divided by 14. Then that quotient, of course, whatever you get, you raise that to that similar power. The outcome will be 2 power 2. So we are done with that revision, and now we can explore our fifth law. Now, which law is this? It is the law of raising a number in index form to another power or index. And this is how the law is stated. X power m raised to power n. Remember, both m and n are powers. So x power m raised to power n. What do you get? You get x raised to power mn. How do you get mn? Simply by multiplying m and n, which are the powers. So I will give an illustration, then we discuss that, of course, example 5. A simple illustration. I have 2 raised to power 3, of course, squared. Whenever you square a number, it means you multiply that number by itself twice. Now, here, applying, of course, the law of multiplication having similar bases, what shall we get? We shall have 2 power 3 plus 3 to give us what? 2 power 6. Now, if you're very keen, the same outcome can be achieved by simply doing this. We say you take 2 power 3 times 2. What do you get? 2 power 6. Again, the same outcome. So in future, if you have such a case where you are raising a number in index form to a power, what will be the outcome? You just consider that base which is there, raise to the product of those powers. That's what you get. Now, before I cover the example, there's something which I've remembered. I need to, of course, now discuss it. We discussed the law
number 3 as being what? The law of multiplication of numbers to a similar power. That was the outcome. Then law number 4 was division of what? Not even law number 4. The first law was multiplication of numbers to, of course, similar bases. That was the outcome. Now the question is, what if you have numbers raised what? Let me give this numbers which have the same power and same bases. So which law do you apply? Do you apply that law or this law? Both law would give you what? The correct outcome. Now let's assume you're using what? This law here. The first law of multiplication of numbers to a similar base. What will be the outcome? Of course, the outcome would be 2 raised to power 3 plus 3 to give you what? 2 power 6. If you're very keen, 2 power 6, the final value will be, of course, 2 power 5 is 32, 2 power 6 will be 64. Now, note that. What about if we apply this law? Where we apply the law of what? Multiplication having the same power. It will mean I multiply the bases 2 and 2 to give me what? To give me 4. Then 4 should assume what? That similar power. If you are keen, 4 power 3 would give you what? The same outcome of what? 64. 4 times 4 is 16. 16 by 4 is 64. So having the same powers and same bases, you can either opt for that law or opt for this law. Which law is that? A law of multiplication having what? Same powers. What about here? A law of multiplication having the same bases. So I hope I've taken care of that issue. Now we go to our example number 5. Now we have the solutions. Now part A, when you have k raised to power r, then raised to power m, what will be the outcome? K raised to power rm, r times m. Part B, we have 3 power 4 raised to power 2. The outcome will be 3 power 4 times 2. In the end, what do you get? 3 power 8. We go to, this should have been C and not D. So C, we have 5 power 3 raised to power a third. What would this give you? 5 raised to power 3 times a third. In the end, what do you get? This and this will cancel. You have what? 5 power 1. Of course, we're supposed to give our answer in index form. Now, part D, we have our last example, 7 power 4 raised to power 3 power 4. This would be 7 power 4 times 3 power 4. That will give you what? 7 power 3 as the eventual outcome. So we come to the end of the coverage of what? The fifth law of indices. We have 5 more to go. But before I end our lesson, let us be able to do what? Note this assignment in regard to law number 5. The assignment is simplify the following, leaving your answer in index form. Roman 1, g power n, of course, raised to power t. Roman 2, 5 power 4 raised to power 2. Roman 3, 7 power 4 raised to power negative 3. Roman 4, 5 power 8 raised to power 1 over 4 or a quarter. Roman 5, 7 power 6 raised to power 7 power 6 raised to power 2 over 3. So let's have the results in the next lesson as we proceed with the coverage of the 9 laws. Of course, we shall be heading toward the 6th law.